We'd like to call the meeting to order if we can all stand for a moment of silence and a salute to the flag, please.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, thank you. Welcome, everybody, to this April 6th, 2017 work session legislative meeting. To start the evening off, we have a student performance of Mr. Chris Rodak, and members of the beginning band will perform for us this evening. So, Chris, it's all yours.
All right, thank you. This is our beginning band. We'll play this for a little bit for you. So a couple full band pieces, and then some individuals will play for you. Last about 10 minutes. So this is part of our beginning band. We had only 20 minutes rehearsed this week. We got PSSAs going, and then we only saw them once. So we just rehearsed before we came, and they did a really nice job. So they're all nervous as well. This is their first performance. So first piece we're going to play for you is called Rio Bravo. It's kind of a longer full band performance for a bunch of kids who just started this year. So Rio Bravo. Sixth graders, I usually get It's kind of the instrumentation fixer for the high school bands and middle school bands. So for the past 4 years, we've got about one tuba, two tubas, or a couple. We're kind of low on low brass. So as you can see, most of these people are brass instruments. And we have a lot more brass and French horns that are in also the band this year. It's about 25 total. We started 5 French horns, 5 tubas, about 8 trombones. Next year, we got our enrollment. It's skyrocketed. We're at 50 beginning band kids next year. So thank goodness Mr. Ballantyne will be more on staff up here. My first year, we had about 10 beginning band students. We're up to 25 this year and then 50 next year. So that kind of allows us to fix any kind of instrumentation holes we have so that we can have 4 balanced high school bands. So this is a super important class. All right, we're going to play Overcome, Had a Band. In my concert band at the high school, we've had kids that are in the beginning band, varsity band. I'm going to call him out specifically, Donnie White. He's a super talented trumpet player. He's a beginning band, he's in varsity band, concert band. Now he's going to be in the high school wind ensemble next year. He's practicing his butt off, started taking lessons. So it's a really, really special class. So Zach, come to Heather. He's going to play some Hope and Joy.
Thank you.
is on all of the band students, beginning band, these guys included, and all of our other students who are going to perform Tuesday, April 25th at the Pirate Game. And we're going to do the Star-Spangled Banner memorized at the Pirate Game. So that's pretty exciting. And that's all we're going
to
report.
Thank you. Well, they don't sound like beginners to me, I can tell you that.
Yeah.
Great job. Absolutely. Great job. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, students.
Did you get a tattoo in the Army?
No, I didn't. You didn't?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't smoke before.
That's okay. You can admit it now. It was a long time ago.
Yeah. You didn't inhale.
That's right.
All right. We can move on to public recognition, and I guess we're going to turn the floor over to our high school principal, Mrs. Beth Williams.
Good evening, everyone. It is a pleasure to be here this evening to honor an outstanding North Hills High School senior, Brian Venturella, as he has attained the rank of Eagle Scout. To achieve Eagle Scout rank, Brian earned a total of 25 merit badges, which demonstrate proficiency in outdoor skills, personal management, communications, citizenship, personal fitness, and much more. He also served as a troop leadership positions, such as senior patrol leader and patrol leader. For his Eagle Scout project, Brian built a Gaga pit for St. Paul's United Methodist Church. Brian, I gotta tell you, I had to Google a Gaga pit. A Gaga pit is an octagonal area, play area, that is fenced in. This project consisted of clearing and leveling an area for the pit, positioning and digging all the post holes, and then assembling the pit. This recreational area will be used by the youth group and other children and ministers throughout the church. Upon graduation, Brian is planning to study engineering. Please now join me in congratulating Brian Venturella. Next, I would like to recognize senior Bridget McColl and sophomore Elena McGoey for being awarded 2017 Carson Scholars. Both are being honored for their continued academic and humanitarian achievements. Bridget volunteers for Meals on Wheels, St. Sebastian CYO, and she also serves as an altar server for the Assumption Church. She also volunteers at the Woodlands Institute for Handicapped Children in the summer, at Berkeley Hills Lutheran Summer Camp, Hands for Service Club, and National Honor Society. Elena is a volunteer at the Pittsburgh Zoo and the National Aviary. She also shadows the veterinarians at the Western PA Humane Society. In addition, she volunteers at Glade Run Adventures in Zelianople. This program helps children with behavioral challenges. Elena also plays the flute at St. Teresa's. What is most impressive about these two students is the fact that these are two students who you can definitely count upon as being future leaders. Their leadership at the high school, just the way they model themselves and their activities, is unparalleled. What makes it even more impressive is this is the fifth time Bridget has been nominated and won as a Carson Scholar, and this is Elena's third time. So please join me now in congratulating both Bridget and Elena McGoey.
Congratulations, good work.
Congratulations.
All right, I guess next we have our Director of Athletics, Mrs. Amy Schuneman. Amy?
Okay. In following with the program, I'd like to start with also a presentation to one of our student athletes. Very well-deserved recognition here today. And I'm going to put up a little slide that will help me as I run through some of his accomplishments. But as only a freshman at North Hills High School, this young man has already amassed a resume that would top anybody's entire high school career. So we're enthusiastically here to support him and congratulate him on his undefeated season as a high school wrestler. He was also the Chartiers Houston champion, the Powerade champion, an outstanding wrestler at that very prestigious tournament. He went on to win our section championship, the WPIL championship, and in the ensuing PIAA championship, which is our first in school history. So again, just an outstanding record there. He was named the Post-Gazette Athlete of the Week in March, and the Post-Gazette Sports Town named him the Freshman of the Year. So it is a great pleasure that I bring up Mr. Sam Hillegas, our freshman wrestler on the wrestling team. The board does have another certificate, but that young lady is not in attendance here tonight, so I will just note that when I get through my report of the winter sports. So we'll move right into the winter sports season summary. And it was a great winter for North Hills. I have some pictures up here for your entertainment, but our boys basketball team had a final record of 19 wins, 7 losses. They were also the North Hills Tip-Off Tournament champions and the Hampton Holiday Tournament champions. They finished second in their section and made it to the WPIL semifinals for the third year in a row and also qualified for the PIAA playoffs. It was just a great team and a great following from the community that supported this team. We had a number of individual accomplishments from the players on that squad. Nick Smith was a first-team all-section, Post-Gazette Fab Five, Post-Gazette Athlete of the Week, Trib Athlete of the Week, broke the single-game scoring record at 44 points in one game, and also became North Hills' all-time leading scorer at 1,773 points, which was a record that stood for about 25 years. So just a great player and student in Nick Smith. Luke Chucka was named to the All-Section Honorable Mention and also a positive athlete. We had Andrew Pulaskis and Cam Taylor, also honorable mention. Here's a picture of those fine men, and as you can see, the crowds that followed them, and just the bottom right picture there is a picture of our seniors that have done a great job representing North Hills for the past 4 years in the playoffs and beyond. Our girls basketball team continued improving. They had a final record of 9 wins and 13 losses. They compete in a very difficult section, and most of their wins came in other outside wins, and that just shows that if they were in another area, they probably would do a lot better. But we have our seniors pictured there, and Jess Bowen and Anna Tresser were named to the second team all section. Our wrestling program, good numbers there, and they had some team accomplishments with a final record of 14 wins as a team and 6 losses. They were the Chartiers Houston Invitational Champions, and they placed 3rd at the Allegheny County Wrestling Championships. The team qualified for the Whippoorwill team playoffs and did win their first match against Upper St. Clair, but fell to Cannon Mack, a perennial powerhouse. Individual accomplishments, as we just heard, Sam Hillegas in his great season there. We also had a number of WPIL qualifiers, which meant they finished in the top three at WPILs, and that was Sam, Nate Mankey, Jake Stoats, Sean Bright, and John McPherson. Sean Bright was also selected to wrestle in a senior showcase out at Moon. There's some pictures of Sam and his medals and podiums. swimming and diving had a great year again. Great numbers on the squads there. The girls had a final record of 9 wins and 3 losses. Boys had a final record of 8 wins and 4 losses. Sydney Davison was our other awardee that we have a certificate for as a WPIL champion. In the breaststroke, she broke a school record in that breaststroke, and she was also named All-American. WPIL qualifiers were Andrew Mahoney, Kevin Levasic, Neil Weibel, Chris McEwen, Matt McHugh, Elizabeth Gorell, Allison Kenny, Madison Cordell, Brianna Joel, Sydney Davidson, and Mary Claire Smith. And out of those, the PIAA qualifiers were the four listed there, Kevin Levasic, Neil Weibel, Sydney, and Mary Claire, who went on to compete at the championships in Bucknell. There's a picture of those students. And WPIL champion, Sydney Davidson, our PIAA qualifiers. And moving on to cheerleading, obviously they did cheer in the fall too, but we're recognizing them as a competition squad. Here they were first at the PA State Cheerleading Championship at IUP. They competed at the WPIL Championship and through their efforts were able to compete at the PIAA Championship as well. They qualified for nationals and they took fourth in the large varsity non-tumbling game day competition, as well as 11th place in the large varsity non-tumble division. We had 4 additional students sign a letter of intent, and we had that on February 1st. Those students were Taylor Berkeley, and she's going to Robert Morris for soccer, Danielle McNally going to Clarion for soccer, Marissa Zupin going to Edinburgh for soccer, and Ben Walter going to Robert Morris for football. I would like to also add just some quick notes about our club sports. Some were in the fall and most were in the winter, so I'm just putting them all in one slide in the winter here. Our ice hockey team finished with 9 wins and 10 losses. They placed 4th in the AA West Division and lost in overtime, unfortunately, in the first round. The JV team completed its regular season with 5 wins, 7 losses, and 4 ties, and they also participated in postseason play. Players selected to the All-Star team were Matt Berner, Jarrett Warwick, and senior captain John Siebert. Our slow pitch softball teams had a great year, best in school history. For the first time, the JV, varsity, and middle school teams all finished above 500. They participated in the playoffs. They were seeded 5th, but as you can read there, they actually made it a little farther. They defeated the number 12 seed and then moved into the quarterfinals to beat Baldwin, and then lost in the semis to Montour. There's some pictures of our slow pitch softball teams, varsity, JV, and middle school. Inline hockey had 16 wins and 4 losses, 1 tie. They were actually the Pennsylvania Classic Roller Hockey League champions for the 3rd year in a row. League honors were Cameron McCullen in 2nd in scoring, Brett Mowinney was 6th in the scoring, and Alec Voltz was ranked 1st overall in the league as a goalie. People in our All-Star game were Christian James, Cameron McCollum, and Alec Voltz. The middle school, as you can see there, had some good players as well and some that went on to the All-Star game. Our bowling team had a good year. The varsity team, boys team, was undefeated in match play and winner in their section. The boys went 25-4-1 in their matches. The girls team went 3-7 and 10-20 in their games during the regular season. The boys team qualified for the Western Pennsylvania Interscholastic Bowling League Championship and came in 9th out of 18 and also participated at regionals. They had individual tournament qualifiers, regional qualifiers, and state tournament qualifiers. And Joe Andrew, Matt Atore, Josh Welka and Andrew Werner. And then moving on throughout were Joe Andrews and Andrew Werner. There's some pictures of the bowling squad. And that completes my winter sports report.
Thank you, Amy. Great job. Thank you. A lot of work there. Sam, once again, congratulations. Mom and Dad, Coach Jones, thank you. Great year. Great year. Something to be proud of. Thank you. Okay, we could move on to board member comments. Before anybody has anything, I just want to make an announcement that our next meeting, April 20th, is going to be held at the A.W. Beatty Career Center. So just make note of that for those of you, the millions that are watching at home, and those of you that are here. Once again, April 20th, A.W. Beatty will be our meeting site for the next meeting. Do we have any other board member comments while we're here?
Yes.
Please.
I would like to say something. After listening to our beginning band, I think it's important for us to know that I know Mr. Newty was there that night, and Mr. Wilgus. The play, Me and My Girl, was fantastic.
Absolutely. Yep.
It was, I always wonder, you go to a play and you think, how can they do better the next year? And they always do. It was absolutely wonderful. Yesterday, we had the opportunity, we were invited to hear our wind ensemble, who is in New Jersey, playing for playing for the All East Convention. And it's an honor to be chosen to go to that.
Mm-hmm.
Our music, our arts program in North Hills, in my opinion, is unbeaten. It cannot be beaten by anybody, mm-hmm. any school district around us, even though we have good school districts. The thing that really means something to me is I always cry when I go to these things. It's just my nature or my, it's just the way I am. But I think about the fact that all we ever read about are the bad things that kids do. That's the only thing that's in the newspaper. And yet you go to these things, which not only exist in our school district, but exist in other school districts, and you look at these wonderful, talented, hardworking, intelligent students, and I would, I just had to say that. I think we're so lucky, and I am planning on starting a newspaper with good news. I don't know whether or not I'll get any people to buy it, but does anybody want to chip in with me?
Well, I agree with you totally. No, but I would just say that, well, she's not here right now, but Amanda Hartle does a great job of pushing out all the good things that
Absolutely.
We're doing on our Facebook site and through
our
email.
But that's
blast.
Our Facebook. I mean, I want a newspaper.
The people in our community all see that.
Oh, and you know what, too? Ed Wilgus was in the paper today, the McKnight Journal. His daughter, you were in it because they have your name in there.
Yeah.
His daughter is the star in Cabaret. We also have so many wonderful graduates. I'm just so proud to be a part of North Hills, and I hope all of you are too.
Thank you, Arlene. Anybody else?
No,
she said she said it all. That's exactly right. Thank
much.
You, Arlene. That's good. Next, we can move on to our student representatives report. And Haley, I guess you're flying solo this evening, so it's all yours.
Senior Nick Smith was named one of the Fab Five Kings of the Court by the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette for boys basketball. Monday, the boys tennis team lost to Pine Richland by a score of 5-0 and lost to Hampton on Tuesday. This makes their record 5-4. The girls lacrosse team is starting off their season hot. They beat Swickley Academy and Butler. Tuesday, their opponent was Seneca Valley, and Wednesday, Quaker Valley, and tonight, Hampton. The boys basketball team started off the year, the boys baseball team started off the year 5-1. They had a successful spring training in Myrtle Beach. They lost to Hampton by a score of 4-1 on Wednesday, and they faced Armstrong, and Friday they play Obama High School. The girls' fast pitch softball team had a great spring training in Orlando, Florida, with the JV going 3-0 and the varsity 2-1. The girls defeated North Catholic in their home opener by a score of 17-3, then fell in their first section game to Seneca Valley on Monday by a score of 0-10. Wednesday they played Butler and won 20-4, and on Friday they will play Shaler.
Thank you, Haley.
Thank you.
I did skip over public comments on the agenda items, but I understand nobody signed up to speak. So.
No one has signed up. Someone has.
So we can now move on to superintendent's report for April.
Thank you, Mr. Wilgus. Mm-hmm. This is our points of pride, tradition, and excellence for the month of April. A lot of this you've heard because there's some really good athletic stuff that occurred, but we're going to go over that anyways. All right, our eighth graders this month created amazing kinetic energy machines as part of the middle school's STEAM program. Students from art, family, consumer science, and technology education worked together to create a machine that would complete a task following a series of chain reactions. The tasks ranged from pulling a tissue from a box to zipping a sweater to turning on a light switch. We had our spelling bees this month, and our Highcliff Elementary sixth grader Tommy Quinn won his school spelling bee to advance to the Western Pennsylvania Scripps Spelling Bee Finals at Robert Morris University. Seniors Bridget McCole and Sarah Kuster placed third in the duo interpretation category for the National Speech and Debate Association qualifier. Students in Sean Clunan's music technology class learned how to collaborate and connect recording components such as microphones, drum machines, and mixing boards to create high-quality audio and video recordings using the high school's recording studio in our library. Ross Elementary sixth graders went head-to-head in a battle of scientific knowledge during their science fair. Congratulations to Gracie Helper, who won first place with her project examining the physics behind a catapult throw. And Sadie Dunlap won second place with her project detailing how different drinks affect teeth. And Parker Sederi won third place with his project on sand dunes. We had a Pittsburgh Opera workshop this year where the professional singers from the world-class voices from Pittsburgh Opera introduced our gifted education students to the wonders of opera during a special workshop. Seventh grader Anthony Wiles advanced to the state level of the National Geographic Bee in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. It's the first time a North Hill student has qualified to compete in the state level Bee in more than a decade. This month was Read Across America Month, and throughout the North Hill School District, elementary students promoted the importance of literacy with a full week of Dr. Seuss activities in honor of Read Across America Day. Seniors Maddie Bohm, Allison Trainer, and Sarah Clem are in the midst of leaving their marks on the high school library. All three girls are members of the high school's graphics club and are designing, creating, and installing custom artwork on the library's pillars. Each of the library's 13 pillars eventually will feature a quote selected by teachers in each department that they feel captures the spirit of their subject matter. Our musical, Me and My Girl, where our high school actors perform Me and My Girl on stage late this March as this spring's musical. So thanks to all of our North Hills community members who came out to support this year's show. And we recognize Sam tonight, but again, Sam is the Hilligus is our first ever PIAA champion in wrestling. Sam won the 113-pound weight class, and you saw a lot of his accolades. So congratulations, Sam, and that's a heck of an honor, particularly for a freshman. We also recognize our swimmers, but congratulations to those who medaled in the WPIL championships and advanced to the PIAA championships in swimming and diving. Sydney Davidson took first place in the WPIL, and as Amy stated, she also has a school record. In leadership, Cancer Awareness Week at the high school raised more than $700 to benefit Our Clubhouse, which is an organization that supports families of those who are diagnosed with cancer. This year, sophomore Juliet California took over the campaign, which was started by her sister and class of 2016 graduate Margot California, along with fellow class of 2016 grad Sarah Glass. Each day, a different cancer was recognized. 1,235 pounds. That's how much McIntyre Elementary students donated during the Buildings Change Makes Sense fundraiser. The fundraiser was part of the Project Playground, which is McIntyre Elementary PTO's fundraising campaign for the new playground equipment to be installed at McIntyre Elementary. Highcliff Elementary and McIntyre Elementary students and staff raised nearly $29,000 during two Jump Rope for Heart fundraisers for the American Heart Association. Highcliff tallied $15,573 and set a North Hills record as it was the highest amount raised during a Jump Rope for Heart event in this district's history. And McIntyre came in a close second with their first building ever fundraiser that raised $13,175. And the thing I like the most, if you look in the top picture, that's our principal jumping rope with the kids. High School's National Honor Society sponsored a blood drive in partnership with the Central Blood Bank in support of our students who are currently battling the serious illnesses. Students donated 48 units of blood that will be used to help 144 local patients. FBLA students at the high school brought back the big cookie for one day only for a special sale to benefit the National Kidney Foundation. Students helped bake the 1,200 cookies and raised $1,098.27, with their one-day cookie sale making them one of the largest donors statewide for PA's FBLA's Chosen Charity of the Year. High school principal Beth Williams, guidance counselor Nicole Weber, and Dean of Academic Affairs Dr. David Barkovich are spreading North Hills initiatives around our country and the academic successes that we are having with our academies. This trio was chosen to present at the Teaching Matters Conference at Gordon State College outside of Atlanta and at the National Academic Advising Association's Regional Conferencing in Pittsburgh. North Hills is one of only two high schools chosen to present from our region, which includes five states. Middle school teachers Joe Welsh, Larry Dornkamp, Rich Texter, and Rick Roth, middle school principal David Lieberman, and assistant superintendent for secondary education Dr. Johanna Venata, were selected to present to fellow middle school teachers and administrators about our Project Connect, North Hills School District's one-to-one initiative at the Pennsylvania Association for Middle Level Educators Conference. Mr. Lieberman and Dr. Venata spoke about the rollout of the project, while our teachers highlighted one of the many ways they use the device daily with presenting on digital storytelling. And our middle school social studies teacher, Joe Welsh, led a national webinar titled Digital Storytelling with Stop Motion Animation for Digital Innovators. In his role as a PBS Learning Media Digital Innovator for Pennsylvania, he is one of only 52 educators serving in this important role across the United States. I will be hosting a one-night-only behind-the-scenes tour on April 25th, starting at 6:30 in the middle school LGI room. I'll give you the opportunity to see various spaces within our building here at the middle school and at the high school, particularly highlighting the middle school STEM Center, our Center of Technology Education, and our libraries. Space will be limited, so I would like to see if you're interested, please RSVP, and I know Amanda has put some things out on our website for that event. We do a lot of great things. You hear a lot of good things about that in our Points of Pride, Tradition, and Excellence. You see public recognitions of our students. And what I'd like to do is give you an opportunity to see some of our spaces. And that's really what that tour is about. So if you're interested and would like to join us, please come out. I know Dr. Barkovich is also going to join me for that tour. So if we have to break up into smaller groups that evening, we are going to do that. So thank you. And that's our Points of Pride, Tradition, and Excellence for the month of March.
Thank you, Dr. Manarino. We can now turn it over to support services, and that would be Mrs. Spade.
Is Mr. Thomas going to make a...
He is first.
John, you need the computer.
No. Okay. Well, we can ask Mr. as part of the... If
yes.
You don't mind. Yeah, you're on. Unless you want to wait till the end.
You all have our award recommendation letter. Mm-hmm. Before I get into recapping all of the low bidders for you, tonight's the motion that or the action that I'm looking for tonight is a little different than what we've done in the past, just a little bit different. Normally, when you vote to award a contract, it's conditional to the contractor's successful completion of the post-award documents, which means we're asking them for their insurance forms and their bonds and a number of other attachments to go along with their contract. And if they fail to provide the insurances and execute the contract, then they fail that condition that you've set forth in your award. So we have that condition like we always have in the past, but there's another condition. And it's because the timing, it's due to the timing of the approval of the site plan by the Ross Township Commissioners. So it has been through the Planning Commission, and the Planning Commission has recommended the project for approval to the commissioners, but not without a little bit of complication. And the complication arises due to the stream that's on the east side of the softball field. Over the past couple of years, there have been some erosion events that have occurred in and around the manhole, and the neighbors are very concerned about the erosion. They see the school district as the only developer on McKnight Road, and of course they believe that the erosion is perhaps solely attributable to the school district's past developments. And I've met with them in person after some of the Planning Commission meetings, and I think they've got some valid concerns. However, in developing the site plans for the project, your civil engineer, CEC, has met the ordinance. So the condition that's there is a pre-existing condition. Nevertheless, the township wants to ensure that the township and the school district are working toward a mutual solution to do whatever they can to mitigate any future erosion. And CEC has been meeting with the township's engineer, Gateway engineers, to try to come up with that mutual solution. And it's my understanding that they will arrive at that solution before the 17th, and any additional work that has to happen in getting that to that solution will be done as a separate project that is done in later years. It may even occur after the construction of the McIntyre addition is completed. Let me just say this also. I have found that the Planning Commission and their engineers, they've been incredibly fair with their interpretation of the conditions and the work that is proposed. And I am confident that they will come to a fair solution on how to proceed with correcting any erosion problems that are occurring in the stream. So it's with that I want you to know that there is that condition. So even though you're voting, if the commissioners do not approve it on the 17th, this will go, these awards will go into limbo until that gets resolved. Okay, so the first award would be to DeMarco Construction, familiar name here in the district, the original general contractor for McIntyre and Highcliff and the high school library. And his base bid is $1,685,600, and it's also including adding an alternate for $5,600, and this is to add cabinetry above the lockers in the hallway in the addition instead of having a visual display board. So his total award would be $1,685,600. Next is the plumbing construction contract with Nexus Construction. I don't know that this company, have not done any work with them in the past. Relatively small contract, base bid only of $153,140. Next, we have the HVAC construction contract, East West, another familiar name here in the school district. They were the HVAC contractors on the Ross Elementary project, did a fine job there. Base bid only, an award of $330,200. And then finally, Merritt Electrical Group, they were the electrical contractors on Highcliff and McIntyre as well. In the projects that were done back in 2008 and 2009. Their base bid is $268,000 for a total award of $2,436,940. Does anybody have any questions? Yes, sir.
The HVAC, how are they doing that? Are they tying into the existing system? Are they doing ductless?
The systems there, they're unit ventilator systems, so there's a fan and a coil unit in each classroom. Right. And there is the need, however, to connect piping onto those units. That piping is actually going to be enlarged, and it's going to have to go down the existing corridor and extend it out into the addition. And they will also be changing the pumps to facilitate the additional load that's generated by these additional classrooms. So it's an extension of the central system.
Any other questions for John?
Any other questions?
No, thank you.
Good. Good, because I was running out of wind.
Thank you.
Thanks, folks.
Yeah, I'm cutting you off. You're cut off. Okay, this is for action. That the board authorize the award of bids for the McIntyre Elementary School with Ross Township's Board of Commissioners approval of the site plan.
You're making a motion, I assume, Dee?
Yes.
Okay, is there a second?
Second.
Okay.
Okay. Is there any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes. Thank you.
Award of bids for the refinishing of two athletic wood floors within the middle high school. Donation of a scoreboard sign at Ross Elementary. I move that items 4 and 5 under the support services be awarded, added to the legislative meeting agenda.
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Spade. Anything else?
I got a question.
Please.
On this scoreboard. I had a couple questions on the donation. So, I mean, it's great they're donating that. Are they going to be handling all the taking down of the old one and the installation of the new one also, or is that going to be?
Dave, do you know if that's part of it? The scoreboard at Ross with the donation. Do you know that the dismantling of the old scoreboard and the new school and the installation of the new scoreboard, is that all included?
This whole thing came up while I was on vacation. I knew nothing about it.
We'll get back to you.
We're going to put it on top of the old.
Knowing it's coming from the North Hills Youth Football Association, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Knowing those folks, I will bet they're going to take care of all that. Yeah. I really did. Just my opinion.
It's a good organization.
Yeah. I'm going to speak for them, but
yeah, I would assume that that's part of the scoreboard process. But I will find out and I'll let you know.
Right, it is, and you know, my son was in an organization, so I know it's a good organization. But then, I guess the other question I was going to ask, now the old scoreboard, is that totally done, or is that something that can be refurbished and put somewhere else?
It was an older scoreboard that was at a different facility and then moved to Ross at one time, and it's now to the point where the parts are just not able to, replacement parts aren't able to be purchased at this point, so it's dying.
So similar to the gymnasium.
Yes. Yeah. Very much so.
Okay.
I think it was around when Lou Nudy was playing youth football. So.
They didn't have that.
Before they had a placement.
They didn't have that.
I'm sorry. That was just a joke. Okay.
We're good. All right. They use candles.
Yeah, that's right. All right, Dee. Thank you.
You're welcome.
We're going to move on to education. Mrs. Bender.
Okay. The AIU Educational Services Agreement. The IDEA Use of Funds Agreement, and Notice of Adoption of Policies, Procedures, and Use of Funds. Are there any questions about this? There being none, and we'll go to the second one, that we're going to be asked for approval for Penn State University Science Competition, May 14th through May 16th, 2017. Again, any questions? The third one is student parking permit fees. Does anybody have any questions about that? Mm-hmm. I think basically, just to make this known, we have not had an increase in parking fees at the high school for 10 years, and we are going to be raising the fee from $35 to $15. The other way. $35 to $50 annually. Any questions about that? There being none, I make a motion to add to the education, to add to the agenda the education items 1 through 3.
Second.
Thank you. Thank you, Mrs. Bender.
You're welcome.
We move on to athletics and activities. Mr. Muha, looks like you got a few things going on.
Yeah, we have several items on the agenda tonight. Number one, request approval of student-initiated club titled the So Fabulous Club, SEW. Number two, girls slow pitch softball continued recognition as a club sport in 2017 reimbursement. A lot of these we just saw on the presentation. Number three, bowling club continued recognition as a club sport in 2017 reimbursement. Number four, ice hockey
continued recognition as a club sport in 2017 reimbursement. Number five, inline roller hockey, continued recognition as club sport in 2017 reimbursement. Number six, that the board approved the Latin Club attending the PAJCL convention at Penn State University, May 19th through May 21st. And that the board approve attendance to the PMEA All-State Festival in Erie, Pennsylvania, April 19th to, April 22nd.
Mm-hmm. In Erie.
In Erie, okay. Yes. So are there any questions on any of these items?
Mm-mm. Nope.
Okay, that's so. I move that items 1 through 7 under athletics and activities be added to the legislative meeting agenda.
I'll second it.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Muha. We don't have anything on the agenda for Beatty. Mr. Mnudi or Mrs. Bender, anything you want to say about it?
Yes, okay. I would just like to, recognize the students of the month at Beatty for February and March. James Advanced Computer Programming, James Jacobs III, and in Advertising Design, Lauren Tate from North Hills.
Thank you.
And that's it.
Thank you. Good news. Okay, Mr. Nudi, you were kind enough to volunteer to take the personnel action items this evening.
There are four items on the personnel personnel for agenda for action, resignations, appointments, change of status, leaves of absence, all of which are discussed in executive session. I move that items 1 through 4 under personnel be added to the legislative meeting agenda for approval.
Second.
Good. Thank you, Mr. Nudi. We don't have anything under policy this evening, so we're going to move on to community and intergovernmental relations. Maybe Mr. Yeomans.
Just one item, and that's the appointment of the voting delegates for the PSBA Delegate Assembly meeting. That's the annual School Boards Association meeting in Hershey, PA. We usually have a few voting delegates for that meeting. I'd like to add that to the agenda.
Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Yeomans. I'll take finance this evening in the absence of Dr. Nolish. We have several items there. General fund bills. The capital project fund bills, the budget transfers, the payroll for the month of March 2017, resolution 2017-5403B tax deferred annuity program employer non-elective contribution resolution.
What was that?
One more time? Okay. That's number six. The informational item is the summary of revenue and expenditures for 2016, 2017 through February 2017. And the informational item, the revenue summary for 2016-2017 as of February 2016, unaudited. Are there any questions or comments on any of those items?
No questions, but on the budgetary stuff, Dave, I know you're just back from vacation and all, but is there anything any red flags that we should be looking at here? I looked through everything, looked like it was tracking normally.
No, your biggest issues are on the revenue side, having to do with some of the state funding, specifically the Plan Con, and it's whether or not they will issue another round of Plan Con funding.
I think the budget that was voted on out of the House, it looked like it had Plan Con in there, but it didn't have transportation.
They had about $30 million for PlanCon, which requires about $300 million a year. So they had about a 10% funding.
Mm. That's good news, Dave.
Which in reality is only going to fund the interest on the bond that they issued last year.
Right.
So no, they don't have anything in the budget to speak of for PlanCon for next year.
So that's
now I'm concerned about this year.
Right. We still haven't received our reimbursement for this year.
Well, they haven't issued the bond yet for this year.
Good gosh.
Phew. We have time. I'm sorry. It was a joke.
Mm-hmm. We obviously did get some money this year. What we got this year was for last year.
Yeah.
It was like the fact
maybe that we're just going to be off a year from now on.
I always like the fact that you're always put under pressure as our business manager, and we as a school board are, but the state legislature sure takes their time getting this done. And you do an excellent job, Dave. I don't know how you do it.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't. You have to almost guess half the things.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, thanks, Dave.
I will make a motion to add the finance items to the legislative meeting agenda.
Second.
Thank you. Okay, prior to closing the meeting, are there any additional public comments that anybody would like to make? Then I'll rush to the podium at once now. Okay, that being said, I will call for adjournment of the meeting. Excuse me.
We're done?
We're done.
We're done.
That's it.
Okay.